Hello guys and welcome back to Accelerate Academy. So today we are going to do the sixth lecture from the cell signaling as part of the Cooper summary series. Guys, this is really important. This lecture is important because in this we are going to talk about the MAP kinase, right? So जो भी MAP kinase से related रहेगा आपका जो Janus kinase हो गया, JAK-STAT हो गया, no sorry, Janus हो गया, ERK हो गया, ERK signaling हो गया, तो ये सारे हम इस लेक्चर में आज करने वाले हैं. So guys, it's really important that you listen carefully and if possible try to make notes also from this. Okay, so MAP kinase is actually one of the major pathways of signaling, signal transduction, which is activated downstream of both the receptor as well as the non-receptor tyrosine kinase. So we have talked about the receptor and non-receptor tyrosine kinase in the previous lecture, and in that we have seen that the MAP kinase gets activated. ठीक है? अब उसके आगे का हमें पढ़ना है. MAP kinase pathway, it refers to cascade of protein kinases, yeah, and they are highly conserved in evolution and hence they play important roles in signal transduction in all the eukaryotic cells ranging from yeast to humans. ठीक है? So, अब इसमें कौन कौन की एलिमेंट्स हैं? So, they are the serine-threonine kinases, which are the MAP kinases. And MAP का फुल फॉर्म क्या है? Mitogen activated protein kinases. Now, please remember that there are again the serine-threonine kinases. हो सके तो एक टेबल बना लो जहां पे आप लिख सकते हो MAP kinase and कहां पे phosphorylation होता है. That is the serine-threonine kinases. ठीक है? So, that are activated in response to a variety of growth factors and the other signaling molecules. And so this is just the introduction. We are talking about here about the MAP kinase and कहाँ कहाँ पे available है. So in yeast, MAP kinase play important role in controlling the variety of cellular responses, including mating, cell shape, and sporulation. In the case of eukaryotes like C. elegans, Drosophila, frogs, and mammals, they are ubiquitous regulators of cell growth and differentiation. इसका मतलब क्या? हर जगह important है MAP kinase. So it is actually initially characterized in mammalian cells belonging to the ERK family. ERK kya hai yahan pe? Extracellular signal regulated kinase family. Guys, you need to remember all those things, okay? Because aaj jo hum karne ja rahe hain mainly aapke CSR ke part C section mein aata hai. The central role of ERK signaling in mammalian cells emerged from the studies of the RAS proteins. Aur RAS hame malum hai, it's an oncogenic proteins. If suppose mutation happens, it is going to cause the cancer. ठीक है? And this was found in the so it's an oncogenic proteins of the tumor viruses and it caused sarcomas in the rats and hence it was named RAS. ठीक है? Now it induces proliferation of normal mammalian cells. अब सोचो अभी इसमें interfere या mutation हो जाए, so what will happen? It is going to block the growth factor, induce cell proliferation. ठीक है? So it is not only capable of inducing the abnormal growth characteristics of cancer cells, but also required for the response of normal cells to growth factor stimulation. And that's why you cannot target RAS for the chemotherapeutic for the cancers, because आपको मालूम है अभी कि in order to target RAS, it is also going to affect the normal cells growth also. ठीक है? तो इसलिए हम RAS को हम target नहीं बना सकते for the chemotherapy. Now, RAS proteins are again your G proteins, that is your guanine nucleotide binding proteins, which is going to function analogously to the alpha subunits of G proteins, and it is going to alternate between inactive, that is DDP bound, and active GTP bound. So in this case, जैसे कि हमने पढ़ा G protein alpha, beta, and gamma subunits है, so alpha is always associated with beta gamma in its inactive form. So once it gets activated, it becomes it dissociates from the beta gamma subunits and then goes and further activates the downstream proteins. ठीक है? अब यहाँ पे क्या है? RAS protein जो है alpha subunit G protein की तरह काम करता है and it doesn't need any function of the beta gamma subunits. ठीक है? So RAS activation is mediated by the GEF, which stimulates the release of the bound GTP in exchange of the GTP. तो जेफ दैट इज गुआनिन एक्सचेंज फैक्टर, नाम से ही पता चल रहा है दैट इट इज गोइंग टू एक्सचेंज बिटवीन द जीडीपी एंड द जीटीपी. सो फ्रॉम इनएक्टिव इट इज गोइंग टू मेक इट एक्टिव. ओके, नाउ द एक्टिविटी ऑफ द रास जीटीपी इज देन टर्मिनेटेड बाय द जीटीपी हाइड्रोलाइसिस. ओके, दिस आल्सो वी हैव सीन इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर. नाउ दिस इज स्टिमुलेटेड बाय द इंटरैक्शन ऑफ रास जीटीपी विद द GTP is activating proteins, and this is how the RAS proteins are regulated. So whenever we talk about G proteins, you need to talk about the guanine exchange, guanine nucleotide exchange factor, and GTP is activating protein. So ये दो आपके जरूरी हैं in order to regulate the G proteins. ठीक है? So let's see in the figure over here. So as you can see here. Here we have got the RAS which is bound with the GTP. So you have the inactive state mein, theek hai? Now to convert into active state, GTP has to be exchanged with the GTP, and this is done by the guanine nucleotide exchange factor. Theek hai? Now what happens, this becomes active. Now this is active, it is going to further activate the downstream proteins for the signal cascade, and then it will become inactive after it is going to terminate its activity by GTP hydrolysis. Theek hai? The GTP hydrolysis कैसे होगा, with the help of the gap, that is your GTPase activating proteins which is going to help in hydrolyzing the GTP which is bound to the RAS. So अब क्या होगा, GTP जैसे hydrolyze होगा आपको मिलेगा GDP, और ये phosphate कहाँ जाएगा, it will go and bind to the downstream proteins and activating them. ठीक है, activating downstream proteins. अब यहाँ पे आपका RAS का काम हो गया है. ओके ओके, सो इट इज इंटरेस्टिंग टू नोट दैट म्यूटेशन ऑफ RAS जीन्स इन ह्यूमन कैंसर हैव द इफेक्ट ऑफ इनहिबिटिंग जीटीपी हाइड्रोलिसिस बाय द RAS प्रोटीन्स. गाइस प्लीज रिमेम्बर, दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट स्लाइड. ओके, सो द म्यूटेटेड RAS प्रोटीन्स विल रिमेन इन द एक्टिव जीटीपी फाउंड जीटीपी बाउंड फॉर्म. तो क्या होगा, so it will drive the unregulated proliferation of the cancer cells. वहाँ पे आपको growth factor की भी जरूरत नहीं होगी to initiate the activation of the RAS protein because it is always in the active form, and hence it keeps on giving a signal to proliferate the cell. Okay, so autophosphorylation of these receptors leads to binding of RAS JEF via their SH2 domains. So SH2 क्या था आपके, SRC homology 2 domains. ठीक है, now these are actually localized in the inner leaflet of the plasma membrane. Okay, so how they are attached, you can see that they anchor to the inner leaflet of the plasma membrane with the help of the lipids at the C terminus of the RAS. So this is the SRC which I was talking about earlier, and this is your RAS protein. ठीक है, तो आप यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं कैसे यहाँ पे ये लिपिड की हेल्प से यहाँ पे अटैच है टू द इनर लीफलेट ऑफ द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन, यानी कि क्या, साइटोसोल की तरफ है आपका RAS प्रोटीन. ओके, सो नाउ जेफ्स देन स्टिमुलेट द एक्सचेंज ऑफ जीडीपी फॉर जीटीपी रिजल्टिंग इन फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द RAS जीटीपी कॉम्प्लेक्स. नाउ अभी आपका RAS एक्टिव है. ठीक है, नाउ व्हाट इट इज गोइंग टू डू इज इट इज गोइंग टू इंटरैक्ट विद द RAF व्हिच इज अ सेरीन थ्रियोनिन काइनेज. Now RAF is going to phosphorylate and activate another protein kinase called MEK, that is MAP kinase, ERK kinase. ठीक है, now MEK is a dual specificity protein kinase because it has got the MAP as well as the ERK also. Now this is going to activate the members of the ERK family by, of course, again by the phosphorylation. Now यहाँ पे आप phosphorylation क्यों बोल रहे हैं, because पूरा kinase pathway है, so you don't get confused कि यहाँ पे हमेशा phosphorylation क्यों हो रहा है. So each step phosphorylation is happening, which in turn is activating the downstream proteins. Okay? Now where it is happening, in on the threonine and tyrosine residues which are separated by one amino acid. So here you can see the threonine 183, tyrosine 185 of the ERK family. Okay, now once it is activated, this ERK is going to phosphorylate variety of target proteins including other kinases and transcription factors. So when these transcription factors are phosphorylated, they get activated and they go inside the nucleus and carry out the gene expression. Okay, so this is nothing but the summary of the MAP kinase like what we were studying till now. Okay, so let's see how exactly it is being done. Look at the figure over here. Okay, so what do we see first thing? It is the binding of the ligand to the receptor. Okay, so let us say that it is binding to the receptor over here. What happens? The dimerization happens, autophosphorylation happens, right? Now, once it is phosphorylated, it is recognized or it becomes the binding site for the SH2 domain. Now, what will happen once the SH2 domain is there? So your guanine exchange factor, that is along with the SH2 domain, it goes and binds. अब इसका क्या काम है, Jeff is going to activate your RAS by exchanging the GDP with the GTP. So what is now happening, it is activated, your RAS GTP is now activated, which in turn is going to activate your RAF. ठीक है, विद द हेल्प ऑफ द जीटीपी हाइड्रोलिसिस राफ इज एक्टिवेटेड. ओके, नाउ द राफ इज गोइंग टू फॉस्फोराइलेट्स एंड एक्टिवेट्स द मैक, दैट इज योर मैप एंड अर्काइनेज, राइट. तो ये आपका फॉस्फोराइलेट हो जाएगा. नाउ विच हैज गॉट द डुअल स्पेसिफिसिटी प्रोटीन काइनेज एंड इट इज गोइंग टू एक्टिवेट द अर्क अगेन बाय फॉस्फोराइलेशन. सो ईच स्टेप यू कैन सी दैट इट इज हैपनिंग विद द हेल्प ऑफ द फॉस्फोराइलेशन स्टेप ओनली. ओके, नाउ कहाँ पे उसने किया है? सो वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट दीज टू पोजिशंस, राइट, द थ्रियोनिन एंड द टायरोसिन, 183 एंड 185, थ्रियोनिन एंड टायरोसिन पोजिशन. सो फॉस्फोराइलेशन यहाँ पे दो पोजिशन में हुआ है. Finally, when this gets ERK, the ERK is activated after phosphorylation, it is going to phosphorylate other nuclear and cytoplasmic target proteins with the help of the ATP. Okay? So this is how the entire kinase pathway is actually getting activated. And each step you can see that it is always the phosphorylation which is happening. Sirf starting mein aapko ek bar GTP lagta hai, uske baad se aapko hamesha ATP lagta hai. Okay? Guys, please remember this pathway. It is really very important. ये part C में questions इसी पे ही based बनकर आते हैं. Okay. So the fraction of activated ERK translocates to the nucleus where it regulates transcription factors by phosphorylation. तो अब तक हमने ERK तक पढ़ा था. ERK क्या करेगा finally? यहाँ पे अगर आप देखोगे तो यहाँ पे phosphorylated है. So it can either go to nuclear or the cytoplasmic proteins. ठीक है. Now, in this regard, it is notable that primary response to growth factor stimulation is the rapid transcriptional induction of a family of approximately 100 genes called immediate early genes. So, in this pathway, mein kya ho raha hai? All these downstream proteins are actually nothing but helping in the activation of the immediate early genes. Theek hai? Now, the induction of many immediate early genes is mediated by the regulatory sequence called serum response element. Now, which is recognized by complex transcription factors, including serum response factor and the ELK1. ठीक है, अब तक क्या हुआ? ERK ने और भी जो बाकी nuclear and cytoplasmic proteins हैं, उनको phosphorylate कर दिया. ठीक है, and all these are going to help in the activation of the immediate early genes. Now, ये कैसे होंगे? With the help of the serum response element, और इसको bind करने वाले transcription factor को हम बोलते हैं serum response factor and the ELK1. ठीक है. I know थोड़ा सा complicated हो रहा है because there are so many things you need to remember. See, once ERK is getting phosphorylated, okay, and the other cytoplasmic or nuclear proteins it can phosphorylate, they can come inside of the nucleus. Now, once it comes inside of the nucleus, it is going to phosphorylate the transcription factor ELK1. Okay, now this ELK1 can, one second, let me just highlight. Okay. So it got phosphorylated. Now this is going to bind to the SRF, SRE. What is SRE? Serum response element, which is in going to bind with the serum response factor. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे एक बहुत बड़ा complex सबका बन गया. Now this entire thing, okay, phosphorylation will stimulate the activity of ELK1 as a transcriptional activator, leading to the immediate early gene induction. ठीक है, तो अब तक हमने क्या पढ़ा? लिगेंड बाइंड करता है रिसेप्टर काइनेसेस आपके टायरोसिन रिसेप्टर और नॉन रिसेप्टर दे के डाइमराइज. व्हेन दे गेट डाइमराइज व्हाट हैपेंस? इट इज गोइंग टू एक्टिवेट योर रास प्रोटीन्स. रास प्रोटीन्स को एक्टिवेट करने के लिए जेफ लगेगा. रास के बाद आपके पास दूसरे डाउनस्ट्रीम प्रोटीन्स रहेंगे जैसे मैक हो गया, अर्क हो गया. ठीक है, ऑल दे गेट एक्टिवेटेड एंड फाइनली अर्क विल गो एंड एक्टिवेट द एल्क वन व्हिच विल गो एंड बाइंड टू द एसआरई एंड एसआरएफ एंड फाइनली हेल्पिंग इन द stimulation of the immediate early gene induction. ठीक है, तो ये जो पाथवे था आपका मेरा भी क्लियर हो गया है. ओके, द सेम थिंग इज रिटन ओवर हियर. सो द ERK phosphorylates एंड एक्टिवेट्स द ERK1 एंड व्हिच प्रोवाइड्स अ डायरेक्ट लिंक बिटवीन द ERK फैमिली ऑफ मैप काइनेसेस एंड इमीडिएट अर्ली जीन्स. Now, once this immediate early genes themselves into transcription factors, their induction in response to the growth factor leads to altered expression of the battery of other downstream genes called the secondary response genes. So these alteration gene expression directly link ERK signaling to the stimulation of cell proliferation, which is induced by the growth factors. So overall, this MAP kinase pathway, it is actually helping in the induction of the immediate early genes and the secondary response genes so that it can help in the stimulation of the cell proliferation. Okay? Now there are certain additional pathways which are associated with the MAP kinase. So that also we can see which is happening in the mammalian cells. ठीक है, तो अभी तक हमने क्या पढ़ा था अबाउट द ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स, राज रहेगा, राज राफ को करेगा, राफ मैक को करेगा, मैक एयर को करेगा, एंड अर्थ विल कैरी आउट द सेल सर्वाइवल और द प्रोलिफरेशन डिफरेंशिएशन. नाउ वी ऑल्सो हैव गॉट द अदर अदर एडिशन टू दिस मैप काइनेज और मैप पाथवे ऑल्सो. That is, it also contains JNK, that is Janus kinase, and P38 MAP kinases. Okay, so activation of JNK and P38 is mediated by the members of the Rho subfamily of small GTP binding proteins. So here again, you have got the GTP binding proteins like RAC, Rho, and CDC42, which is going to activate again your ERK activation. Okay, the cascades which are responsible for the ERK activation. Now, the protein kinases cascades leading to JNK and P38 activation appear to be preferentially activated by the inflammatory cytokines or the cellular stress, and which leads to the cell, which leads to the inflammation of the cell or the cell death. ठीक है? एक तरफ हमने क्या पढ़ा था? Growth factor is going to help in the proliferation and the differentiation of the cell. राइट right? दूसरी तरफ हम क्या पढ़ रहे हैं, वेन एवर द स्टिमुलस इज द रिलीज ऑफ द इन्फ्लेमेटरी साइटोकाइंस और द स्ट्रेस, दैट टाइम इंस्टेड ऑफ रास यू हैव गॉट द रैक, रो और CDC42, व्हिच इज गोइंग टू एक्टिवेट द अदर काइनेसेस लाइक MLK, TK1, MEK, एंड देन दिस इज, इट इज गोइंग टू एक्टिवेट द मैप काइनेस, काइनेस 4, मैप काइनेस, काइनेस 3, which in turn will activate your JNK and P38. ठीक है? और जब ये activate होते हैं, तो eventually it is going to lead to the inflammation of the cell or the cell death. ठीक है? So अभी आपको मालूम है that ERK is responsible for the proliferation of the cell and JNK P38 is responsible for the inflammation and cell death. So this table is really very important, guys. Please understand and try to remember. So even if you don't remember these many proteins which are involved in the inflammatory cytokines pathway, but please remember that JNK, P38 and ERK ultimately ye MAP kinases jo hai wo kis function ko lead karenge. ठीक है, सो ERK इज गोइंग टू लीड फॉर द प्रोलिफरेशन डिफरेंशिएशन सेल सर्वाइवल, वेयर JNK P38 इज गोइंग टू लीड फॉर द इन्फ्लेमेशन और द सेल डेथ. ठीक है, सो दिस टेबल इज रियली वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, प्लीज रिमेंबर इफ पॉसिबल. नाउ Like ERK, the JNK and P38 MAP kinase can translocate to the nucleus and phosphorylate transcription factors that regulate the gene expression. Okay. So the multiple MAP kinase pathways thus function in all the types of eukaryotic cells to control the cellular response to the diverse environmental signals. So signals kaise ho sakte hain? Aapke growth factors bhi ho sakte hain, stress bhi ho sakta hai. Okay, so the specificity of MAP kinase signaling is maintained at least in part by the organization of the components of each MAP kinase cascade. So, yahan pe hum kya baat kar rahe hain? Protein scaffold ki. For example, in the case of ERK, KSR scaffold proteins are there. Theek hai? And we have got the upstream activators like RAF and MEK into the signaling cascade. सो वी नो दैट यहाँ पे रैस जब एक्टिवेट होता है तो रैफ है, मैक है, अर्क है और फिर हमें रेस्पॉन्स मिलता है. ठीक है, तो इन सबको एक कैसेट की तरह से इंक्लूड करके रखा है एक कॉम्प्लेक्स में विद द हेल्प ऑफ द KSR स्काफोल्ड प्रोटीन्स. सो इससे क्या होगा, एक साथ ही इमिडिएटली इट इज इजी फॉर द प्रोटीन्स टू कैरी आउट द सिग्नल फ्रॉम वन प्रोटीन टू अनदर. ऐसा नहीं है कि रैंडमली इट हैज टू वेट फॉर द प्रोटीन्स टू कम एंड हिट सो दैट इट कैन फॉस्फोराइलेट. दे आर ब्रॉट टुगेदर विद द हेल्प ऑफ द स्कैफोल्ड प्रोटीन्स लाइक KSR. ठीक है, सो एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस स्पेसिफिक एसोसिएशन ऑफ दीज प्रोटीन कैनेसेस ऑन द KSR स्कैफोल्ड, एक्टिवेशन ऑफ RAF बाय RAS leads to specific and efficient activation of MEK, which is in turn activates ERK. ठीक है, तो जो जितना सामने रहेगा उतना अच्छा आपका सिग्नल पास होगा. So following phosphorylation by MEK, ERK dissociates from KSR and can translocate to the nucleus. ठीक है, now the distinct scaffold proteins are involved not only in organization of other MAP kinases but also in association of other downstream signaling molecules. So this physical association of signaling pathway component as a result of the interaction with the scaffold proteins play a very important role in determining the specificity of signaling pathways within the cell. Yani ki kya? Either go for the cell proliferation or go for the cell death. So jaise ERK pathway ke liye we have got the KSR scaffold protein, the same way for JNK and P38 also we have got the different scaffold proteins. So guys, that's all for today, and let me remind you once again, this lecture was really very important because you need to remember the MAP kinase pathway very well so that you are able to give the correct answers for the part C questions. ठीक है, तो अगर नहीं कुछ समझा है तो प्लीज लेट मी नो थ्रू योर कमेंट्स और थ्रू योर मैसेजेस इन द चैनल, इन द टेलीग्राम चैनल. And if you like the video, please share and subscribe with your friend circle. Any suggestions are always appreciated. And you can also write to us on excelsureacademy1220@gmail.com. So till then, take care guys and keep watching.